Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Final Fantasy 15 here on Pastiche of Skin. It's an absolute pleasure to have you. Thank you very much for coming back. I'm glad you've actually been enjoying what we've actually shown here on the channel. This has been fun playing Final Fantasy 15. I'm odd. I'm odd that this is a 10-year game that actually worked out. This isn't a Duke Nukem or anything of its sort. We've actually managed to find something that's pleasant. It's enjoyable. I don't get this. That's actually a pretty good shot of that dude. So, just to catch up on where we were, we're on to chapter 4 of the game. End of chapter 3, we were looking to go and see what this disc is like from the distance by looking through a viewfinder. This dude was waiting for us. And, I don't like him. I don't like him. He was around during Kingsglaive. He obviously was on the side of the enemy. He was on the side of Niflheim on Kingsglaive. He was on the side of, but he was at least informing them. This dude has a plan. This dude has the same mop of hair as the dude we saw at the very beginning of chapter 1. Like the pre kind of amble that we saw inside the head. He's got the hair for it. He's got a plan. This dude is fucking Kadaj. This dude is Sephiroth. This dude is what was the one that actually turned into a god a couple of times? The one with the fucked up clown face. I can't remember the name. Whatever the fuck, that's what this dude is. So I'm sure he's actually going to be fucking with us for the rest of this game. He's actually turning us around, showing us where we need to go and what's going on with the Archeon, because it seems to be summoning Noctis to it. So we're going to go and visit Titan, who is obviously holding up the power plant that's actually powering this place. So this is going to be interesting. So let's find out what the crack is as we go on to the next chapter of Final Fantasy 15. The bro trip continues. Chapter 4, Living Legend. As the land is rocked by terrorists, Noctis is racked with headaches. The self-styled man of no consequence advises the would-be king to go and head to Archeon's call. Though loath to believe a suspicious stranger, the four friends nevertheless find themselves with no recourse but to follow Arden to the Disk of Kothis, where Titan is said to slumber. So we're going to be checking out Titan. This is the kind of song that I've seen in teaser trailers, this character was in the Duske Gay demo, or at least it was actually the press demo they showed. We saw a fight with him where he's like, he is a giant Titan. He's like, oh, smash! And actually attacking the team. I'm pretty sure I'm going to die because I have no items. I have no money. I have done zero missions outside of the main campaign. So I'm hoping that I can because I know I'm not doing any of the side missiony stuff, I think I might just sell all the crafty shit that I have sitting in my pockets and use that just to dump into Phoenix stones and healing potions, because I managed to survive just with the barest of hope. Fuck you, man! Fuck this dude! I don't know why I'm driving this, but yeah, I'm holding down R trigger and I'm just flicking the direction to make sure I follow him. So this is essentially forcing me to pay attention for once. Right. Creepy old dude. Exactly right. Yeah, I think that's actually a pretty good plan. Watch your shit, hold on to your pockets, make sure this fucker does not lose your sight. Or leave your sight. That would be terrifying. Grand mal seizure while at the wheel of a car. I'm sure there's lots of people who have to suffer with that and deal with that on a regular basis. That would scare the shit out of me. Yeah. Yeah. So we have to stay with you in the camper van? Oh, great. Well, obviously we need to save the game. We've literally done nothing. Nothing's happened. Like, the chapter started and is making us save the game after doing this one bit of driving. It's just that we have a moment where we're all sitting there looking at Arduin kind of weird. We don't know whether or not to trust him. EXP. Yeah, takes me up to 18. That's all we saw. Arduin looking pretty. Yeah, really? It's obviously you. Ah. What's that one taken of? Right, whatever. That was a wasted trip. Blow the beast whistle to summon enemy combatants. R2 and... Right, so I can summon enemies to fight, to part, essentially just to burn through. This makes sense. So essentially if I summon monsters, I can just beat the shit out of them, get the items that I need from them, and that'll allow me to actually make enough money to be able to buy the things I need to do. Right, that is useful. Okay, and as long as I stay close to here, I can pretty much heal up as much as I need to. Right. Interesting. Okay. So. So we're getting little kind of cutscene-y moments, cutting to where she is right now. I'm healed! I'm healed! She is a miracle worker! No, it's Kuraga. Well, fuck off then. I don't need you to come here. She is a sweetheart, but she has sent you to open up her own little mini hospital. Wait, these motherfuckers... So she's obviously been here. Why are we not commenting about this? Why are we not trying to find Luna Freya? What does that mean? Well, the more reason he needs to clean up his act. That's all sorts of fucked up. You guys are assholes. Fuck you guys. Oh, shit. Was that you that was cupping my balls last night. I'm just going to go and fight some things and not grind, but, you know, kind of like get myself ready. I've got 10 of those, one of those. I've got one of those that what... by way of Noctis's powers. So essentially, that item shouldn't work on any of my teammates, only me. Alright, since she spawned in out of nowhere. So, is there a diner here? There usually is a diner in these places. No, no diner, just a fuel stop and a place to buy weapons. Let's see what we got here. Right, we literally have no money for anything. Well, finally he has a shield that I could probably use, but let's go and fight some monsters. Yeah? What was it? It was L1 and the D-pad, was it? I'm trying to think. Right, so we're just going to go out in the wildernessy bit here a little bit. What's this? Enjoy a bite of batter served on a platter, but the taste of victory. Okay. Good for you, man. So these little shacks probably actually have something on each one of them related to what Igni does. So. Alright, so I can. So that whistle will do that if I actually am in a right enough area. So maybe what I need to do. What I need to do is find a group of enemies, I suppose, and then I can summon more of them. Oh. Right. I don't seem to be summoning any enemies. Oh, tiny feather. Oh, that's so sweet. I'm assuming there's going to be bad guys down here that can punch a little bit. Maybe? Yes? No? Maybe? Look at that dong in the distance. Yeah? Don't seem to be summoning any monsters anywhere around here. You are just a big giant child. You don't know what to say. Seriously? Summon monsters! I want to summon the monsters. You told me to do so. Or you told me how to do so. Assuming the whistles do multiple things, I might actually have a whistle for, like, how to get chocobos. That kind of thing. This seems like the kind of place monsters could spawn. Dude! Whoa, that is one big looking motherfucker. See, I don't want that to attack me. I want smaller things to attack. There we go. That looks more like it. Alright, well, at least that was fun. Let's summon more of these bad boys. Yes? There we go. So this is actually a good way to kind of get items that we want to get. And practice combat, I suppose. Boom! Okay, precipitation. That's good. Alright, am I poisoned? Yeah, I am. That sucks. Whoa! Nope, 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 nope. Fuck that. Yeah, don't worry, we're leaving, we're leaving, we're leaving your ass alone, Jesus. Huh. That was mildly perturbing. That toad is like level 27. I'm not going to go and pick a fight with it. Just because I was actually doing this to kind of get items to sell does not mean I have a death wish. So, yeah, if I grab this map and then I go back to the rest point. The spot where you last rested. Boom. That'll actually teleport me back. I can go into the shop, see what I can sell with those items, and maybe afford at least one Phoenix down. So I think that's why I think that's what's going to have to happen for the gameplay in this. I'm going to have to actually... I'm not doing missions, but maybe grind a few things just so... Does that actually work, functioning now? Yeah. Imagine I do rent a chocobo, I have to do like the chocobo unlock mission of some sort. Right. Let's see what you got. What's your wares? Ooh, 1,000 cactar. Yes. Memories of Final Fantasy 9? Oh, that's very nice. I don't have any money, though. That's upsetting. Alright, so those Vortus were 120. Nice! Okay. So that's how I meant to actually get the money that I need in this. Oh, I'm so tempted to actually start just selling everything that I have here. I mean, imagine I could probably use a lot of this stuff for... Unusable currency? I don't know. It's one of those things where it feels like I'm actually using... Dropping things or selling things I shouldn't. But imagine that's what these treasures are. I mean, either there's something for crafting or there's something for... selling, and I don't want to sell everything when then find out that I kind of need, not that I needed it, but I was going to be able to actually upgrade stuff with it. Do you know what, screw it, it's going to have to go, everything's going to go. Selling everything. Oh, some laser sensors and stuff sound like a really useful thing as well. They could actually be, screw it, I'm not going to be doing any crafting, I'm going to be just burning through this as fast as I can, so. Oh, it feels so wrong, so very wrong to be doing this. Oh. See, I'm sure there's things like the rusted bit and stuff that were sitting there that I needed to actually upgrade my main weapon if I ever went back to... Sid, but it feels so stupid to be doing this. But at least I have 5,000 gil, Which also means that because I am an idiot, I am going to spend 200 of that actually on the Final Fantasy IX soundtrack. I want to be able to listen to it whenever in the car. Alright. Don't know what that repair kit's going to ever be used for. Oh, it's just a treasure. I can reuse it. I can use it for crafting. So I need to have a couple of those at least. So grab three of those. I'm going to grab four of those. I have high elixirs, potions. It's got the basic stuff that I need already there. So yeah, that sounds about right. Okie dokie. So that should be me prepared. I hope. I think. Maybe. Wait, what's in the shop in here? Is there any price difference? No, there isn't really on that stuff. Do you know what I really wish there was for the regalia? Was a way to actually set yourself a playlist for the audio. Because as it is now, I have to shuffle randomly to get the Final Fantasy IX soundtrack. So is there anything else I need to do here? Maybe pick up weapons might be a good move. Weapons mean better damage. Better damage means easier kills. Alright. Shit, yeah, that's an upgrade. Yeah, that's a goddamn upgrade as well. All of these are upgrades. So much for all the money that I had. Spirit increment. What? Incrementally? Made vest that can resist bullets. Reduces ballistic damage mildly. Vitality. With garnet, enhances strength and maximum HP. Doesn't really matter. Nothing really gonna stand out to me there. So yeah, this means I can actually pretty much everybody gets a boost in their attack damage now. Yeah, so you're taking the air step sword. And I'm going to give you blade and your kite shield. You get an upgrade to the cutlasses and the mithril lance. Prompto, you get calamity. And I think the circular saw is actually the better of the two. Just double checking that to be able to see. Yeah, it is. Yeah. So the auto crossbow is still long range as well, though. Tempted. Should I stay with the auto crossbow? I don't know. I'm going to go with auto crossbow because I just like... I think he actually is better whenever he's got long range to use so he doesn't get yanked into the fight. It also means that he can keep back and keep me healed if need be. I need to give something to him to actually have a different move. Tempest looks interesting. It's a good solid hit, but it's not really that useful. I need something that actually does really good solid one-hit damage. You're still sitting on the Avengers, aren't you? So I'm going to probably leave you with those. Sort of the wise, I can go to here. And sort of the Wanderer. And magic-wise, I will give you Blizzard. There's nothing new to put on there. Bam, that's that sorted. Maybe take a wee look at the Ascension list to see what we got. We got 61 points to spend, so what are we going to use it on? That's the question. Well, that's what I was saying, teamwork. So I might actually go for techniques, because this is stuff for Ignis, Prompto. Yeah. Heavy damage to a single enemy with a powerful swing. Depletes tech by 2, though. Oh, Royal Guard? I Whether frontal sweeping depletes attack bar by 3? Jesus! I'm not liking that. That might actually be useful. I don't have enough for it. But whenever if I can do it whenever I take damage as well as I give damage, I can always have it ready to do regroup. Unless he's already down. That's the only question. Warp Factor 2. Mr. Sulu, Warp Factor 2. These all seem to be pretty useful. It just feels like there's so few choices that I kind of like don't feel like got any choices to use. Where was the new one? Oh, there it is there. The Amigear. Or Amigar, whatever it is. Conjure the arms. Boost abilities. Yeah, reduce depletion. Alright, so that reduces it and gains it over time. I'm going to build up both of these because it feels like these are the kind of things... Oh shit, yeah. Nah, I don't have enough for it though. At least that's it set up now that I can actually do, I get it from attacking and I've got 13 points left just to spare. Didn't bother actually doing anything for the magic there really, I still don't feel like I'm going to be using that much magic. Yeah, I don't have enough to do that trick now. Yeah, I'm going to use that. So no matter what, as long as I actually have a warp point to go to, I'll heal up. And if I can heal up from that, then I can generally have a moment to take a moment's breath, which would be useful. Alright, so that's me wired up and ready to roll. He says that I can't really... I've got nowhere to really go afterwards. Or it's like no turning back. So I was better to be prepared before I actually leave with this guy. Nope, I'm working around with that. So this is kind of like the same as at the end of the first chapter where it said, like, you won't be able to return back to this area for a while. And then it didn't actually become a plot at all. Right, I'm following you now, again, and I'm driving. Why am I driving? So that's the basic premise. Alright. Oh, right. At his feet. Can we see him? We haven't seen him yet. He's actually in beneath that. Interesting. Yeah, I was going to say. Yeah. Damn right. So we're going to wind our way down here into this wee spot underneath the disc. Yeah, he's a cool customer, that's why. Yes, indeed. Yes. Yes, I can see. I can see. It's pretty much, I need to clean my glasses. It looks quite foggy, actually, without them. Even with them, I mean. I was just going to let that conversation end because it seemed to be a little bit awkward for me to stop it whenever it was like two lines away from finishing. Yeah, you're surprising because I have no idea who you are and this plot seems to be passing pretty fastly. Indeed, yes.
I don't care, I'm just sitting here reading my book.
Okay. That's mildly troubling. Of course, there is a ship, which means I'm going into a trap. Yay! Okie dokie. Trying to get a good look at this, but I can't really see anything. Is this dude actually, like, is he kind of, like, encrusted in the ground because he hasn't moved in so long? Because I think I can see the structure of, like, musculature and body parts, but it's also weird because everything seems to be dead around here. Did they build, like, cities and stuff in the wake or grounds around the Titan? It's very weird of them to do so. Oh, these are ruins probably of the stuff that was here whenever Archaon stopped the meteor, I suppose. Makes more sense. Or I'm actually walking along his ribcage, which is weird. Are you serious? Is that a royal tomb? Whoa. Weird. Very weird for it to be here. Obviously they knew it was there because they actually would have seen it because it's so out in the open. So they're essentially waiting for me to arrive to take this power. Oh, yummy. Great to have that in my chest. Bam. That was nice. So with the Blade of the Mystic and... Whoa, there we go. Ow. Ow, my head. Ow. Ow. Okay, okay. Time to run. Eep. God damn it. Whoa. Yep, thank you, chap. Let's get up here. That was not fun. Oh, wow. Hi there, big guy. What was that? Sorry about that, dude. Yeah, dude. You are Mathis. Let's take a look to see if we can get it either closer to you or move around. Alright, so I thought that kind of like there was a wee flash where I could have probably re-scored that without... Whoa. Yeah. Yeah. I'm not going to stick around where there's any... I'm not going to attack you, buddy. I'm not going to attack you. Ah, shit! Ah! I don't know how to block these motherfuckers! Yeah, why was I not able to, like, air combo these guys? That was very perturbing. And there was nowhere to warp strike to. Where am I meant to go to now? Alright, so just keep on going this way. Oh, alright, cool. Might have got a pickup of Firewhelm here. Alright, there we go. That's got my MP back up fast. So I just needed to actually, like, go into cover, I suppose, is the way to do it. Right. This is going to get interesting. There's a lot of guys flying around there. Work our way across without actually getting their attention, hopefully. That's some breezy heat. Okay. Come on, Noctis. Bleed out the pain, keep it up. Oh, don't fall. Oh, hi there, buddy! Whoa! That looks pretty cool, though. Oh! Yeah, let's get over there. Come on. Do you want to get clear so I can get clear? Oh, there we go. Yeah, what? Ugh, keep moving forward. Just keep swimming, just keep swimming. Oh, that's my inventory full. Slidey slide. Nice recovery there. Okay, it wasn't that far, dude. Alright, yeah, literally I am. Well, yeah. I'm a Cydia? Is that what they're called? Okay. It's gotten very, very dark all of a sudden. It's just like... Doctor Strength increased by 50%. Awesome! Right, cool. I actually got like a wee boost from just having a few words from Gotti. Alright, lead the way. Yeah, it's okay, dude. It's the heat. Yeah, that's a bit odd. Where do, oh, there it is. Find it. Oh, great. It's getting hot in here. So take off all the clothes. I am getting so hot, I'm gonna take my clothes off. And now we find them. Uh-oh. Yeah, can we please go somewhere that I can... Alright, we're doing some of the monsters, but I can heal myself at least. Boom. And... Whoa. Down they go. What's that done? Follow the trail? Alright. Is this the trail? Like, am I literally climbing up inside the Titan now? Because it feels weird that it's gone really, really dark. Oh, there you are, dude. Whoa! What are you saying? Holy crap! Okay. Jesus! That was interesting. Yeah. I figured that was a kiss. Oh, whoa. I don't know when he's going to attack. That's more like it. Up we go. Okay. Keep on running. Come on, Gladdy. Yeesh. Oh, fuck you, man. Fuck you. Shit. Oh, man. Boom. Oh, Jesus. Oh, man. I don't know when I have to hit the block. Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay. Jesus Christ. Oh, this is not good. I have no idea what I'm doing. Oh! All right, I'm just going to keep a focus on his hand. Oh, come on. Oh, man, I have no idea what I'm doing. Come on. Down you go, you son of a bitch. Oh, okay. All right, I think I've got this now. I think we've got the pattern. Okay, got it. And parry. There we go. Dodged. You big son of a bitch. Oh, that one hit me. That's not good. Okay, that is not good at all. It's kind of hard to keep the camera on him properly. I mean, my hands are starting to sweat from just the gripping. Okay, that's not where I want to be. Yep, there we go. Got him that time. Yeah. Timed that wrong. Got that right at least. There we go, got it. Ah, man. I don't know which way I'm meant to be looking for him. There we go. Boom, got it again. Oh, okay, Imperial soldiers coming in to attack this thing now. Right, this is going to be interesting. Am I meant to be attacking them? Whoa. You son of a bitch, I didn't even see you coming. Gotcha. Come on, attack. Oh, whoa! There's very little kind of recovery there for that one. Dude! What do you expect me to do? From the Armiger chain. Right. Let's do this. No, Jesus. Ay, ay, ay. Trigger to see Blazara team up. Team up to damage Titan and put their plan into action. Okay. Okay. All right. Nice. Bye-bye to your fist, motherfucker. Oh, shit. That means the asteroid's gonna come down. What? Oh. So Luna Freya was here. Whoa. Well, so he's gone. Shit. So, yeah, this place is starting to fall the fuck apart. Yeah, can we get out of here? Are you guys going to attack? No. Really? Oh, of course it is. Hi. Yes, you didn't. Right. Yeah, we're not going to die here, so we're going to jump in there. Yeah, I know. The Mark of Arcanian, a symbol of Titan's favor. Very nice. Archeon? Well, so that was that chapter done and dusted. Yeah. The Trial of Titan. That was fun. I don't even have words for it. So, of course, it was like kind of like a very staged boss battle with a lot of parrying and dodging. I didn't seem to really actually do damage to him except for that one last bit where it said, like, do 9,000 damage and you can get a massive boost of damage from the bazaar. But I kind of got into the flow of it and the blocking. It's less like that I need to level and prepare for these fights, more that I just need to actually have the ability to hit things to a rhythm and wrestle a little bit with the actual camera, which is a bad problem in this. It is not good at all. That's really, really a big problem. Like, the camera is completely losing control over what it was paying attention to. And I'm pretty sure I could have attacked the enemies there, but I just focused on them and let the rest of the guys deal with them. But yeah, that was fun. That was the end of a chapter. Wow. Oh man. Yeah. Wow. Wow. So yeah, of course we've got some photographs from Prompto to go through. Yeah, that's actually Ignis looking quite sassy. That's that dude standing there looking around. Where was this? Oh, this is in the store. Ignis again. Gladdy looking sweet, isn't he? Ooh, what was that? Oh, that was actually attacking his hand in some way, shape, or form. Oh, I like that one. That looks kind of cool. I actually want that one for a wallpaper, to be honest, actually. So, yeah. Some decent images out of that chapter. So this was chapter 4, Battle with the Titan. Damn, that was actually really enjoyable. I hope you guys enjoyed watching me play through this chapter of Final Fantasy 15. Of course, you can always go and see the whole way through. You can stay with us, join us for all the extra entertainment that is actually available in the Final Fantasy game. I was stunned to mild silence during some of the action-y parts of that. It was just, it looked good. And like that was a really cool set-piece battle. I hope there's, like they said, there's 6 Archeons, so there's probably 6 battles like this with creatures, which hopefully don't get too steel. That's one thing I'm a little bit concerned about. But yeah, that was quite enjoyable. So yeah, thank you very much for watching, guys. If you enjoyed the show, you can always hit the subscribe button that's sitting right up here, or you can hit the thing over here that actually will be showing episodes of other shows that I do here on the channel. So until that time, until the time you come back for another episode, I will bid you all adieu. So same bat time, same bat channel. I will see you all in the next episode. Bye.